How's it going? This is Evangelist Rayford Johnson, also known as Brother Ray. Today, during this quick cast, I felt led by the Holy Spirit to do a deliverance prayer. And, you know, a deliverance prayer is basically casting out demons. According to Mark 16, 17, 18, God has given us power to do that. Luke 10, 19 says he's given us power over scorpions, over serpents, and over all the power of the enemy. You know, that was one of the first things Jesus told his disciples to do, was to cast out evil spirits. Okay, many people are bound up, you know, whether you call it possession or oppression, it's the same thing. Basically, the kingdom of darkness is having their way within the individual. But Jesus, right, Yeshua HaMashiach, I like to use his Hebrew name, has given us the power to break the enemy's back, to put him under our feet. So that's what we're going to do today. But I want to put out a disclaimer. You know, as I'm praying, okay, what you might feel things moving within you. Many people do. You might feel heat because I'm going to call down the Holy Spirit fire. Okay, you might feel things gripping you. You might feel nauseated. Sometimes people throw up. So I would suggest that you get a glass of water and a bag or maybe a trash can in front of you. This happens at times. So, I mean, it's nothing abnormal, okay? This is what happens when demons are exposed and they start manifesting. You know, some people will speak out. Some people will lose control over their body, okay? So, but we're going to pray and I'm going to believe God. I don't know what's going to happen. All I do know is that the Holy Spirit is going to have his free will. Okay? And just because you don't manifest does not mean it doesn't work. Okay? It's not working or didn't work. Right? The Word of God is powerful. Okay? The main thing we're looking for is the fruit. Right? The change in the behavior. Right? The change in the feeling, the emotions, whatever's being attacked. So, there's also a couple things that we got to discuss before I go into this deliverance prayer, which is very critical. We have to repent. One of the main reasons why people don't get delivered is because they don't fully repent for their sins. Okay? Can't be any unrepented sin in your life. And I'm not talking about sin that you're being challenged with. Okay? That's probably why you need prayer. I'm talking about sin that you don't want to let go or won't let go. For example, you know, you have an individual that has a girlfriend that he's sleeping with, right? Committing fornication, which is against God's commandment. He's like, well, you know, I want deliverance, but I'm still going to have sex with my girlfriend. Well, that's unrepented sin, okay? And your sins are not forgiven because you continue by your own free will to live in sin, okay? So at this case, the deliverance will not work. There will be no, you know, impact. Okay, you might make some demons mad. That's all it's going to do. Second is, we have to forgive. A lot of people say, well, I can't do that. We have to forgive. Mark 11, 24 says, as we stand praying, right, we must forgive as Christ, you know, our Lord has forgiven us. Okay? Now, if you say, well, I can't, you know, I just don't feel it. That's okay. By faith, just say, Lord, Holy Spirit, help me. Give me the power to be able to forgive this person. That right there, okay, that just shows that, you know, that shows an act of obedience, that you're willing, okay? God honors that. And he will give you the grace, the mercy, the power to be able to forgive that person. Okay. Second is you got to renounce, you know, all sin in your life. Witchcraft, sorcery, black magic, whatever it is. And this is what you say. You say, for example, if you've been involved in horoscopes, you say, I renounce horoscopes in Jesus' name. I renounce all black magic in Jesus' name. And you just go through that. You know, even after, like I said, before I start the prayer, you could even pause it and just start renouncing things. The reason I'm saying, because, you know, in the spirit realm, a lot of times these demons have legalities because the person hasn't renounced what they've been involved in. For example, gang members. You know, if they stay in covenant with that gang, and, you know, then they haven't renounced it. Okay? So that means the enemy still has a grip on them, still has a stronghold on them. You know, first they can't be forgiven because they have not renounced the gang. The Bible says you can't sit at the table with the Lord and demons at the same time. You just can't do that. Okay? So what I want you to do, the Bible says examine ourselves to make sure that we're in faith. So examine yourself. Say, take some time to examine yourself and play this prayer back over and over and over until you feel the manifestations gone. Okay? But like I said, you want to, you know, even after, like I said, before the prayer starts, you know, just pause it and make sure you renounced it. Repent for any sin. You know, go to the Lord. Say, Lord, is there, show me in my heart. Shine a light in my heart. You know, in my soul. You know, show me, is there any unrepented sin? Is anyone I need to forgive? You know, I'm willing to repent and renounce it. You say, I repent for this and I renounce it. You know, if you've been involved in Ouija boards, I repent for being involved in Ouija boards and I renounce being involved in Ouija boards. And I think it's, sometimes it's good to go a step further, you know, renounce things, not only what you've done, but for any of your ancestors have done, you know, stand in that gap, because that's how you, a lot of times, that's the key to breaking generational curses, okay? So, we're going to proceed now to the prayer, and like I said, we're going to break generational curses also. The Bible talks about that. You know, I don't have time to go deep into that, but you can, you know, do your research, right? There are generational curses that go from generation to generation, especially within witchcraft, okay? You know, a lot of times I'm praying for individuals. I prayed for someone that their grandfather was involved in Freemasonry. And in Freemasonry, they worship idol gods and involved in rituals to pagan gods. And as I started praying, now he wasn't involved in Freemasonry. His father wasn't involved in Freemasonry. His grandfather was. And as we started praying, and I said, in the name of Yeshua Mashiach, I said, the spirit of Freemasonry, the strong man of Freemasonry, I bind you up. And I'm telling you, this guy started screaming and yelling. And he's in a business suit. This is outside in a parking lot. And this thing just came out of it. He started just almost growling. His eyes went back where you couldn't see his pupils. But long story short, he got delivered from that. He had no idea that was in him. And that was causing the curse. Because what is a curse? Okay? A curse is an assignment that a demon has against someone. Okay? That's what a curse is. Okay? It's an assignment from the kingdom of darkness. But in the name of Jesus, we can break those assignments. There are sometimes assignments, curses of premature death, where there are demons assigned. Many times because, you know, you never know. You have relatives that were involved in occultic practices, and, you know, they made deals with these demonic entities that they would be blessed, but they would give up a grandson or a family member in the future. So that's a binding contract that they had with that demonic entity. But praise God, Galatians 3:13, Jesus has redeemed us from that curse, from the curse of the law, right? It's been severed by the blood of Jesus, but we got to walk in our authority. So we're going to start right now. And like I said, as I'm praying, I want you not to focus on me, but to focus on Christ, because he's your deliverer. I'm just agreeing with you. Okay, and like I said, you might feel these things, so, you know, don't be alarmed. That's normal. So we're going to start praying right now. We're going to go from the mother's side to the father's side, down to generations, and so, you know, and this is for, like I said, this is just a general deliverance prayer. If you need more prayer afterwards, you can contact me through my website, DougExposed.org. Please fill out the form, your number. You know, if you want to be prayed over on Skype, or FaceTime, let me know. We can do that. We can arrange that. Okay, I actually prefer that. So here we go. All right. So Lord God, and like I said, this is a hope. Like I said, hopefully you've paused the tape before this and have repented, you know, for your sins and have renounced things before we get to this step. Okay. So right now you should have just been pressing play. Now you're hearing me about to go into this prayer. So Father, we come before you right now in the name of your Son, Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ our Lord. Father, we thank you according to Hebrews 10 that we can come before your throne boldly, Lord God, because of the blood of Yeshua that washed our sins away, Lord God, and even you said even cleanse our dirty conscience away. We don't deserve it, but we thank you for your mercy and your grace. Luke 10:19 says you've given us all power over serpents, over scorpions, over all the power of the enemy, Lord God, all the power of the devil. We thank you, Lord God, for that. Father, right now I decree the blood of Jesus over the viewer that is watching, and over myself, over their family and my family, from Satan and his demons trying to retaliate from this deliverance session. Father, we just thank you that you're warring angels over there protecting them, that no weapon formed against them shall prosper, according to Isaiah 54:17, over their family or my family, Lord God. Father, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, if there be a spirit of sorcery, witchcraft, black magic, white magic, horoscope spirits, pharmakia demons, spirits that come in through drugs, through meth, through marijuana, through heroin, through e-pills, through alcohol, generational spirits that came, Father God, through their use or through the bloodline or through the umbilical cord from the mother's side to the father's side to the 10th generation. I command these spirits right now to manifest right now in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Fire of the Holy Ghost from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. I command the fire of the Holy Ghost to burn these demons out of their hiding place, out of their nest, in the name of Yeshua Mashiach. Angels of the Lord, according to Hebrews 1:14, go in right now, remove these spirits out of their hiding places with your swords, out of their hiding places, out of the stomach region where they like to hide, in the chest region right now. Bring them out of their nest right now. I want the strong man of every one of these spirits. The strong man. Angel, put a chain of fire around the strong man's neck. And every spirit under their authority, break up their crown, their rings. Father God, every omelet they got, every piece of jewelry they received from Satan themselves right now. Confiscate all their powers, all their jewelry right now. In the name of Yeshua HaMashiach right now. Fire of the Holy Ghost right now. In the name of Yeshua Mashiach, we say, out to the pit of hell. Out to the pit of hell. In the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, Lord God. Right now, in the name of Yeshua Mashiach, if there be a spirit of anger, violence, rage, I command it to manifest right now. Anger, violence, and rage from the mother's side to the father's side to the 10th generation. Every spirit that came through the bloodline, through the wound, I command manifest right now. Fire of the Holy Ghost right now from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet all over their body. Fire of the Holy Ghost right now. Angel, right now, remove these demons out of their hiding place, out of their nest. Get the strongest one, the strong man, over each one of these categories. Bind them up right now. Do the same thing. Break off their crown, their jewelry, every power they got right now, along with every demon under their authority. In the name of Yeshua Mashiach, I say, out to the pit of hell. Out to the pit of hell. In the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Fire of the Holy Ghost right now. Everything come out. Father, if they've eaten anything or drunk anything that was consecrated to demons or came from a witch or a sorcerer or a warlock, Angel Lord, I command it right now. Angel, put your sword in right now. Remove every demonic thing that has come in through a curse of food or drink, I command it right now. Come out of them now in Yeshua's name. Fire of the Holy Ghost right now. Come out. We send it right now to the pit of hell in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Right now. Father, every spirit that brings mental torment, there's demons that talk to them in their head, bring the hallucinations. Those demons, right now, the ones that keep them up at night, insomnia demons, right now, insomnia demons, nightmare demons. Fire of the Holy Ghost, right now, we break up every demonic altar in the mind. Every demon that's been hiding in their mind, we destroy the altar in their mind and their brain right now in Yeshua's name. I command these demons to manifest. Angel of the Lord, apprehend the strong man and every spirit under their authority. Right now, deactivate their powers. Break off all their jewelry right now in Yeshua's name. I say, fire the Holy Ghost right now. From the crown of their head to the sole of their feet, through the fingertips, to their bones, wherever these demons are hiding. Fire the Holy Ghost, Angel of the Lord. Go in right now. Remove these spirits out of their hiding place, out of their nets. We command in the name of Yeshua Mashiach, out in Yeshua's name to the pit of hell. Don't return back anymore. And that goes for the same for all the other demons we just cast out. Out in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, Lord God. Every spirit behind secret societies that came in, or gangs that came in through rituals, through oaths, through incense, from the mother side to the father side, to the 10th generation, every demon, whether it be Freemasonry, Greek letter organizations, right now, cults, Wiccan, whatever it may be, street gangs, mafias, every demon that came in through oaths, through rituals, through human sacrifices, blood sacrifices, incense, whatever it may be, right now, I command the strong man, manifest right now in this individual. Fire of the Holy Ghost from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. Fire from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. Right now, remove this demon out of their hiding place right now. The strong man and every demon under authority. Angel, put your swords in for the stomach area, the chest area. Command them to come out of the head. We break up every demonic altar that was created in their mind, in their brain right now. We bind the spirit up, the strong man up right now. We break up its crown. Loose your grip over their mind, their emotions, their will, their body right now. Right now, Angel Lord, we send these demons right now to the pit of hell, to the abyss. Out in Yeshua's name. Come out right now. Fire of the Holy Ghost right now. Come out, demons. All out right now. Out in Yeshua's name. Father, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, every spirit of premature death, the demon that's been assigned to kill them, whether through drugs, through violence, suicide, whatever it is, every demon, Father, under the strong man of the spirit of death, whether it be suicide spirits, reckless spirits, accident spirits, I command right now, we break off the curse right now. We command right now these demons to manifest in Yeshua's name. Manifest right now in the name of Yeshua Mashiach. Angel Lord, we put a chain of fire. Put a chain of fire around the strong man of the spirit of death and every demon working under their authority. Bind them right now in Yeshua's name. Go in through the back, through the chest, wherever they are, through the blood system, Father God, through the bones. Drive them out right now, every spirit. Fire the Holy Ghost right now. I decree the mighty blood of Yeshua HaMashiach, the mighty name of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ our Lord. I command right now these spirits out to the pit of hell. Out, and we break every curse. Every curse that was associated with these demons that came out, we break it off right now in Yeshua's name. We break it off right now in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Father, every spirit of sickness and disease, cancer, heart disease, whatever it may be, arthritis, Father, we command tumors, high blood pressure, right now, leukemia, whatever it may be, I command right now, they all have to bow down to the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. I command these spirits right now, the spirits that even came through the bloodline, through the womb, through the DNA, right now, we break off the curse right now of this sickness. I command in Yeshua's name these demons to manifest. The strong man of each and every one of these demons, from the mother's side to the father's side to the 10th generation, I command you, manifest right now. Fire of the Holy Ghost right now. From the crown of their head to the sole of their feet, increase the fire. 1,000 times hotter. Burn these spirits out. Angel, go with your sword into the cells, into the blood system, through the bones, through the mind, through the brain, wherever it is. Fire of the Holy Ghost right now. Increased. I decree the blood of Yeshua Mashiach run through their veins, through their body, through the organ. Angel, I remove every demonic nest of these demons of sickness and disease. Right now, bind the strong man in each category right now. Bind the strong man and command these spirits. Loose your grip over their mind, their emotions, their will. We say, out to the pit of hell. Don't return again. Out. The curse is broken. By Yeshua's stripes, they are healed. Matthew 8:17 says that Christ took and bore their infirmities, all of our infirmities and diseases in Yeshua's name, so we do not have to have them. So we decree them healed in Yeshua's name. Healed in the name of Yeshua Mashiach. Right now, every spirit of confusion and torment, Father God, confusion and torment, I command the strong man in these categories of these demons, manifest right now. Fire of the Holy Ghost from the crown of their head to the sole of feet. Every demon that brings the thoughts right now, if there's any that still bring the voice, and drive your sword and break up every demonic altar where these demons got their altars in the mind and the brain. Close up the pineal gland. Fire of the Holy Ghost from the crown of their head to the sole of feet. We bind the strong man and every demon under their authority. We say, we uproot you by your roots. Command all these demons, pack their belongings out in Yeshua's name to the pit of hell. Out to the pit of hell. Come out right now in Yeshua's name. Out right now to the pit of hell. In the name of Yeshua Mashiach, every spirit of fear, strong man of fear, anxiety, panic attacks, fire of the Holy Ghost, we bind you right now. Spirit of fear, panic attacks, anxiety, right now, we bind you up. We break up your crown, your rings, every power and your authority right now. We break up every chain. We break up the curse. Every spirit that came from the mother's side to the father's side, 10th generation, we command up and out. You and all your belongings, out in Yeshua's name. Angel, go and grab all the belongings of these demonic spirits. If there's any devices they left, any chains, any devices, we command right now you uproot it out of this person's body, soul, and spirit. We say, out to the pit of hell. Out in Yeshua's name. Come out. In the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. We just praise you, Lord God. We praise you, Lord God. We worship you, Lord God. In the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Right now, Father, we just glorify you for this deliverance, Lord God. We glorify you for this deliverance in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Father, I thank you for any other contrary spirit, any contrary spirit right now, any straggling demons. Angel, Lord, go in and get these spirits and all their belongings. Bind them up right now in Yeshua's name. We say, out of the body right now in Yeshua's name, out of the soul in Yeshua HaMashiach's name. We thank you for a complete cleansing. Fire of the Holy Ghost, just cleanse them from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet, Father God, through their soul, through their body, just cleansing right now in Yeshua's name, in the mighty name of Yeshua HaMashiach. We decree them set free in Yeshua's name. Lord God, we just worship you and we praise you. Okay, you said that prayer with me. I would like to say it's important that you invite the Holy Spirit into your heart, into your body. The body, the Bible says that the Holy Spirit becomes our body becomes a temple of the Holy Spirit. But we got to ask Him in. Like I said, if you have done this prayer, I'm assuming that you are born again. So if you're born again, you have the right now to accept the gift of the Holy Spirit just by the asking. Okay, Acts 1:8 says we receive power when we receive the Holy Spirit. So I want you to repeat that to me and say, Father, I receive right now the gift of the Holy Spirit, Father God, and the gift of speaking in tongues of my heavenly language and all the spiritual gifts that you have for me to fulfill my destiny in Christ. I receive it right now by faith in the name of Yeshua Mashiach. And I just thank you, Lord God, that you have sealed me by the blood of Jesus. Father God, you have sealed my spirit and sealed it and have sealed any demonic portal has been sealed, closed by the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach. So, well, praise God. If you said this prayer, you know, and like I say, it's important that you meditate on the Word of God day and night. I just did a video on that. You should see it in the playlist. That's important. You got to be followed. So right now, like you said, like the Holy Spirit, Christ has just done surgery on you, uprooted some things. And like I said, you still might need prayer. You might need to pray this prayer again. Or you want to call me. And like I said, if you need more specific prayer in other areas, that's fine. Sometimes, you know, deliverance, you know, happens instantly, you know, right after we pray. Sometimes it's progression, okay? But I know that the Holy Spirit has it, and it has its way today in Jesus' name. So, like I said, you can go to my website, thugexposed.org. I'd like to pray for you further if you need that. But we have some great resource videos, you know, that I want you to take a look at. And also along with some other prayers there of deliverance. So, God bless you. This has been Evangelist Rayford Johnson, Brother Ray. Until next time, God bless.